This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hello there, welcome back once again. This is episode 37. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to factor an ordinarily irreducible quadratic expression into two linear factors, that is, factoring things that we ordinarily couldn't using imaginary numbers. Let's have a look. Our task for this episode is to factor this quadratic expression into linear terms. And by linear, of course, I mean first power only. Now, if you looked at this, you might say that there's no way to factor it. And you'd be right, considering our usual method involves trying to find two things that multiply to 10, but add to 2. And there are no such numbers. If you run into this situation, in order to factor this, we'll need to use the quadratic formula. And just in case you haven't seen the quadratic formula, or maybe you've seen it before but it's not very familiar to you, it goes like this. X equals negative b plus or minus root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a. And just as a reminder, the number in front of x squared is your a, the number in front of x is your b, and the constant term is your c. If you don't have a number in front of x squared, simply use 1. Let's give this a try. We'll have x equals negative b, which is negative 2, plus or minus square root. B squared is 2 squared, or 4, minus 4 times a times c. So we'll have minus 4 times a, which is 1, times c, which is 10. All divided by 2a. Since a is 1, this will just be 2 times 1. The root term looks like kind of a mess, so let's start by trying to simplify what's in the root. We'll start with what we've already got, negative 2 plus or minus what's in the root, divided by 2 times 1, which is 2. Let's try to hack through this. We've got negative 4 times 1 times 10. That makes 40. We still have our 4 before that, and 4 minus 40 gives negative 36. So our equation now becomes negative 2 plus or minus square root of negative 36, still divided by 2. Now that we have a single number in the root, notice that it is negative, and you can't take the square root of a negative number. In order to make this make sense, we are going to have to factor out a negative 1 from the root, so that our square root of negative 36 will become root 36 times root negative 1. So we'll have x equals negative 2 plus or minus root 36 times root negative 1, all divided by 2. However, we do know that root 36 is actually just 6, and root negative 1 can be rewritten as I, so that our equation now changes to x equals negative 2 plus or minus 6 times I, still all divided by 2. Our final step is to divide both terms by 2. Well, negative 2 over 2 gives us negative 1 plus or minus 6i divided by 2 gives us 3i. So we can say that our answer is x equals negative 1 plus or minus 3i. We now have our x value as negative 1 plus or minus 3i. However, this is actually two answers. To show that it's two answers, we'll need to split this into two answers. So we'll say our first x is negative 1 plus 3i, And our other x is negative 1 minus 3i. Our final step to write the final answers in the way that your instructors are going to want them is to move everything that's on the right over to the left. That means for the first x, we will add 1 to both sides and subtract 3i from both sides. To our other x, we will add 1 to both sides and add 3i to both sides. Everything that's on the right side will cancel out. And so here's what we're left with. On the left, we have x plus 1 minus 3i. For our second solution, we have x plus 1 plus 3i. So we can say our linear version of the quadratic we started with is x plus 1 minus 3i times x plus 1 plus 3i. And so that's how you change a quadratic that you ordinarily wouldn't be able to factor into two linear terms. Notice that both of them have imaginary terms, where one of them is negative 3i and one of them is positive 3i. But other than that, they contain the same terms. If the only difference between them is that one of them contains a negative imaginary part and the other contains a positive imaginary part, these are referred to as conjugates. We'll talk more about conjugates in a later episode. For now, thank you very much for watching. We'll see you soon.